Fasten your seatbelt. It's going to be a bumpy night.
Hello, everybody. Hope you are going well today. We are talking about Vox Lux. Now, from the title and poster of this movie alone, I actually thought it was some kind of sci-fi film, but no. It's definitely not. Directed by Brady Corbett and starring Natalie Portman, Jude Law, Stacey Martin, and Rafi Cassidy, this is actually the story of a rising pop star. We start in 99 when Celeste, our main character, played here by Cassidy, experiences a school shooting, and this opening scene of senseless violence is handled in such a haunting and simplistic way. It is done so well. I was absolutely floored. What an opening scene to a movie, let me say. Celeste is only 14 at the time, and it is because of this horrific incident that she is thrust into the spotlight and subsequently discovered as a singer. She partners with talent manager Jude Law and is quickly thrust into fame and stardom. Now, this is where Vox Lux is unlike any other rising pop star, a star is born type story, because we skip the middle of what you would expect a movie like this to be completely. Like, it's just lifted out there and gone. All the part where she would be coming into her own fame and dealing with that and going on tour, all that kind of stuff, it's just skipped entirely. It's gone. We flash forward and now Celeste is in her 30s. She's mega famous and has everything now that she could ever have hoped and dreamed for. Celeste is played here in this section of the film by Natalie Portman, and Celeste's daughter is played by Rafi Cassidy. So Cassidy is actually playing a completely separate secondary role. So she's now the daughter of Celeste. Does that make sense? It kind of threw me for a loop when that first came up in the film. And in this third act of the film, we get to spend a day with Celeste in this pseudo rock documentary style, just following her around in her hotel, doing press interviews, press conference, going out for lunch with her daughter, getting papped, all that kind of stuff. And if you're a fan of Natalie Portman, you will just be floored at this performance. It is so good. She is so volatile. She is so monstrous in her attacks and how she relates to other people. But then at the same time, in the very next moment, she has these real flashes of genuineness that are so endearing and so empathetic. You really want to relate and want to care about everything she's gone through to get to where she is today. Vox Lux is an extremely bold film. I don't think it achieves everything that it sets out to, but drawing a really interesting social commentary and even social political commentary at times, it really does very well. There is this narration by Willem Dafoe kind of randomly over top, which adds this critical analysis just sporadically punctuating throughout the film. It kind of doesn't work, but at the same time, it really works as more of an essay style to the themes that this film is trying to show. I have to as well mention the music, which plays obviously a really key role. The tracks are original tracks by Sia, who was an executive producer on the film, and the music is really great, and I commend Natalie Portman for singing her own songs. I think that's a really great and awesome choice. However, not that she doesn't have a good voice, but Sia has a better voice, and I think that the film would have benefited from Portman not actually singing her own songs in this very specific case. I'm not trying to downplay Portman's abilities. I just think for the crescendo and climax of this amazing, like, 15-minute concert scene, to have a stronger voice projecting these songs would have really elevated it to a different level. So Portman can sing, I'm not taking that away from her, but Sia would have sung it better, sorry. Overall, I'm really pleased and very impressed by a film like this. It's stylistically really bold, really ambitious, really going hard at creating this overlay of social commentary about pop culture and about the world where we are in general. The performances by Portman, by Jude Law, all the performances are really, really great, and the relationship dynamics of the characters are very well fleshed out. This is not a neat little film that you can summarize in a single sentence, and maybe that's why it came and went in a flash. Like, I did not even see this film playing in theaters anywhere near me. I did not even hear about it until much later. And that, I find, is a real shame, because this is a film that has a lot to say and really, truly deserves to be seen. So I can highly recommend Vox Lux if you are feeling bold, if you are feeling out of the box, if you love a bit of Natalie Portman, really go and check this one out. They have been my thoughts on Vox Lux. Make sure you leave me comments in the comment section down below. Let me know if you get a chance to see this one. I'd love to hear your thoughts on it. Don't forget, you can also subscribe to my channel here and keep up to date with all things movies and TV. Thanks again for watching, and I'll see you next time. Bye.